So here we're at the MediaTek booth, and you're showing LTE World Mode.
Yes.
And it's right here. Can you hold this? This is a prototype phone.
Yes, prototype phone.
With a MT6735.
Yes. You can see now we are using the MT6735 doing the CDMA voice call. So now in Spain there is no CDMA network, so we are doing okay.
There it is, 6735.
And 53. 53 is the octa-core solution, and 35 is the quad-core solution. Okay.
So this is LTE world mode.
Yes.
Support every country in the
every
world.
Every mode here is the here. You have the FTTP, LTE, CDMA, EVDO, TDS, CDMA, FTTMA, everything there.
And you say first gen is faster than the vendor fourth gen LTE.
Yes.
So if you talk about a competitor, you're faster.
Yeah, you're faster.
With LTE and faster.
Yes.
And
that is for the category 4 LTE. We are faster than our competitor. This is all the. All these are the field test throughput. Okay.
And single SIM, you are 10-15%?
The reason why for dual SIM we are even faster because dual SIM, you didn't have to some slot to receive another SIM page, and we optimized for this slot so we can have better performance and throughput comparing to our competitor.
So faster, is it Cat 4 we're talking about?
This is the power consumption you can see.
Yeah.
It has a standby. 1XRTT, that means the CDMA, 3G, LTE, we have a very good performance in. This is, the unit is the MediaTek.
Other solutions is other guys?
Other guys, they have higher power consumption.
So it's better with power?
Yeah, better power, the lower is better.
Faster speed, but it's a Cat 4.
Yes, Cat 4 is only Cat 4.
But most of the carrier in the world is just Cat 4, right? Nobody's doing more?
They are trying to have the Cat 6, and it's a migration stage.
In
and
Taiwan
we
or
will,
no?
In Taiwan, in Europe, in US.
Yeah.
And we will provide the Cat 6 CA solution by the end of this year. And this is the major IoT we have passed with the operators. Yes. You can see this is China Mobile. We have Orange. And we have everything. A lot of Europe carriers have passed the certification.
And you're ready for every country?
We are ready for every country. Now you can see this is the field testing we have done in these countries.
So these guys are ready for it?
Yeah, these guys are ready for shipping.
Ready for shipping?
Yeah, we're ready for. We have passed the operator IoT. That means our customer can use our solution to ship on that cast carriers.
That means it's tested in all over the world.
All over the world, yes.
Well, there's no LTE so much here.
Yeah,
it's coming.
No, it's not LTE.
But everywhere where there is LTE, you're supported.
Yeah, we support that. Thank you.
So you buy one phone, use everywhere LTE.
You can say so.
And you can travel with it. You can go other place. You can buy it in one country and use it in another place.
Yes.
You can buy it from China and use it in Europe.
Yes.
Buy it from USA and
if
use it
in... customer just design all the band all over the world, then our solution can support this kind of world mode.
What, how do you do this? How do you do world mode? You change something inside the modem?
Yes, we integrated the CDMA part into our modem. So you can do simultaneous voice and LTE solution. You can do the CDMA call and the LTE data transmission at the same time. Yeah, that's what we're doing now.
And this is just, this for now, is the 35 is just a test phone, right?
It's just a test phone.
With Lollipop.
Yes.
But very soon, brands are ready with this?
Yeah. Very soon, in the second quarter, you will see your customer shipping with this solution, yes.
Second quarter, shipping with the world mode.
Yeah, world mode 6735. I think at first there will be in China Telecom. Yes.
Because the 32 and the 52 is not world mode?
They are not, they are not world mode. Only Star
Freedom. But they are LTE.
They have LTE, but for Star Freedom from the 35 and 53, we have the world mode.
In previously, with the 3G phones, with the last 2-3 years with MediaTek, is not been world mode, or some is possible the 3G world mode?
No, that means we only support those TDS, CDMA, WCDMA.
Not so good
no
in USA.
Not in USA,
USA has not been so before.
Yes, now we are ready for the US market. If we have not support the SVLTE, we'll try to migrate to the SILTE and enhance 1XC holdback to support the US market.
Are we talking about a compatibility with the LTE from Verizon?
Yes.
Also?
They already have that for Verizon and Sprint, and we will try to catch up with them.
these guys.
Okay.
Okay, cool.
Thank you.